Good morning, students. Today I am going to revise chapter 1st, Lakes of India. In GK, chapter 1st, Lakes of India. Dear students, you know, exam is very near. From 1st September, exam will be started, and I hope you are preparing very well and you are studying very well. So today I am revising Lakes of India. You know, lake is the also water bodies. In the lakes it is found much water. Lakes may be small, lakes may be very huge. Like that, you know, in Gorakhpur also lake, Ramgarh lake. In Sant Kabir Nagar district, one lake is there, Bakhira lake. But these are small lakes. Some lakes are found in the worldwide, a very huge, very vast, and it contains a lot of water, much water, and it never dries. So in this way, lakes are also one type of the water bodies. It contains water, much water, and use of water are differentiated for the different purposes. So the people use the water in different way. So you can say that water of the lakes also can be useful, and it can be used also in the different ways for irrigation also. You know irrigation? Irrigation means as giving water to the crops and plants. So in this way also government also use the lakes as to produce electricity. Means power plants. So in this way you must study Lakes of India as first is given, page number 4. Located in Odisha, this lake is made up by 52 streams. It is the largest coastal lagoon of India and the second largest in the world. You know, lagoon is the large lake that is cut off from the main oceans or seas. You know oceans? So from the oceans, some parts can be separated by natural way or by man-made. These are called lagoons. Lagoons are very beneficial for the producing of salts. You know salt? It is very beneficial for producing of salt. In the lagoons in Gujarat, in Odisha, salt is produced. Many plants are planted, means factories are planted, as to produce salt. So lagoon has many importance. So located in Odisha, this lake is made up of 52 streams. It is the largest coastal lagoons of India and the second largest in the world. So this is the which? Chilka Lake. Chilka Lake is found in Odisha. Second, located in 3 districts of Kerala, the lake is known for the snake boat racing, backwater, house boating, bird watching and photography. So this second lake, it is Vembanad Lake, that is located in Kerala. Vembanad. Third, The saline lake in Ladakh has 60% of its area in China. It is known as a famous camping site and is popular for migrating birds. The lake changes its color throughout the day based on the position of the sun in the sky. So this lake, it is found in Ladakh, 60% of its area in China. The name of this lake is Pangong Lake. Nowadays also, Pangong Lake as a region for the battle, region for the battle as top war, you can say cold war, you can say between India and China, Pangong Lake. Because 60% of this lake is found in China and 40% in India. So this lake, Pangong Lake, third. Fourth question, this is the largest island salt lake of India located in Rajasthan. Most of Rajasthan salt production occurs here. Fourth, so Sambhar Lake. In the Sambhar Lake, the producing of salt, means production of salt, is at the high rank. Means a large amount of salts are produced in this lake, Sambhar Lake. It is located in Rajasthan. So you can also prepare question, where Sambhar Lake is located? Where the Sambhar Lake is located? Where the Pangong Lake is located? How many percent of the Pangong Lake is for China? This type of question also you may prepare in your mind. Question 5, statement number 5. This lake partially covers Gujarat, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh and is created by a dam along river Narmada. It is famous now for the Statue of Unity located near it. So one lake is also located as covers Gujarat, Rajasthan and Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh also, means four states. It covers four states. And also Statue of Unity. Statue of Unity located near it. So the name of the lake is Sardar Sarovar Lake. Sardar Sarovar Lake is man-made lake. Sardar Sarovar Lake is man-made lake. From this lake, electricity also is produced. From this lake, as from the help of water, running water, electricity also is produced from this lake. And one a very big statue also is located here. Name is Statue of Unity. Statue of Unity. So this name of this lake is Sardar Sarovar Lake. Last, located in Telangana, the lake is created by the world's largest masonry dam. It was created as project for the green revolution in India and for hydroelectricity production. So it is related to Nagarjun Sagar Lake. It is also man-made lake, Nagarjun Sagar Lake. Nagarjun Sagar Lake is created due to the green revolution in India. And here also, hydroelectricity production, it is found. Means, electricity is produced here. If the electricity is produced with the help of running water bodies, it is called hydroelectricity. Hydro means water. Means, with the help of water, water bodies, electricity is produced. So it is called hydroelectricity power plant. So as with the help of hydroelectricity power plant, electricity is produced here in Nagarjun Sagar Lake, that is located in Telangana. You know Telangana? Telangana is such a state as before 2 years, it is cut off from the main state Andhra Pradesh. From Andhra Pradesh, it is cut off one new state made as Telangana. So it is located in Telangana. So dear student, today you prepare Lakes of India for today's class. Thank you.